tactic.
BSM presents The Tim Meisberg Show, streaming live on WBSM.com and the WBSM app. Call 508-996-0500. Send us app chat messages and open line voicemails using the WBSM app. Now, The Tim Meisberg Show.
Welcome back in hour number two of the program here on Thursday morning. And a big happy birthday goes out to my brother, Michael Weisberg. 40th birthday. So I don't know what he has planned to celebrate it. I think he's got to work. I know he's not bowling tonight, and we're going to miss him. There's only a couple weeks left in the season. We've already resigned ourselves to we're not moving up. We finished we're in the top five, at least the top 10. The last season we bowled. This one, not so much. More like the bottom five. So he can take the night off and go enjoy his birthday with his family, and we'll celebrate him next week when he comes back to bowling. By celebrate, I mean we'll probably lose. So it's a big day. There's a lot of birthdays on this day. Like everybody that I know, this is their birthday. So if it's yours, happy birthday. Also, if you missed the discussion at the top of the program at 6 o'clock, there's another delay for South Coast Rail. In a community meeting last night, Gene Fox, who is kind of the community liaison for South Coast Rail, was talking about the safety tests that still need to be run and basically saying midsummer is no longer the likelihood of when rail service will start, or be later than that. So again, it was supposed to start December of 2023. And actually, I think there might have even been a target start date that was earlier than that. But we heard December 2023. Stuff didn't get done in time. Then we heard late spring, early summer of 2024. Then we heard midsummer of 2024. And now that's not the case either. But it's still coming. It's very close. I would almost guarantee that it's going to happen by the end of the year, but I'm going to be careful and not put any money behind that. But it's going to happen. It may not affect you at all. You might say, well, I don't plan on ever taking the train. But it will affect you when the trains are out there crossing some of the roads you're used to traveling, which is why they have to spend this time running tests, training the crews on the routes, and getting the drivers used to the fact that there'll be trains. So ABC6 has a good story on that you can check out. They attended the meeting last night and got some good information. Also, there's a story that WPRI had about Rhode Island looking to expand some of its liquor laws to allow for more sampling inside liquor stores. And I think that's a great idea because as someone who has been taking part in some of those events at Stevie's Wine and Spirits here in Fairhaven, it's made a real difference in the purchases that I make. So I'm all for that. I think that's a great idea. Again, it has to be done responsibly. You can't let people be coming into the stores and, you know, getting liquored up and then selling them a bottle for them to go home. But controlled sampling to try, because, you know, it's one thing if you're going to go in and buy a $20 bottle of alcohol or a six-pack of beer. You know, you get what you get. if you don't like it, you know, lesson learned. You paid $12 for the beer. Lesson learned, you won't get that again. Now, $12 is probably a 4-pack, but you know what I mean. But when you're going in there and you're thinking to yourself, do I want to buy this $90 bottle of bourbon? Do I want to buy this $100 bottle of scotch or gin or whatever it is that you may drink? Is it worth it? So to have a chance, because it's not like you can go into a bar and say, oh, do you have resilient rye? No, they probably don't. They probably have, you know, Jim Beam or Jack Daniel's rye. They have whatever their distributor supplies them with. Unless you're going to a noted whiskey bar, you're not going to find some of those rarer things to sample them ahead of time. So being able to sample them in the store is very helpful. And that's what's great about Stevie's. Anything with the purple dot, you can sample it before you buy it. Don't take the bottle and open it. Ask. They have open bottles in the back that they'll pour you some from. But there's been things that I've walked in and sampled and tried and said, oh, no, that's not for me. And other things that I've said, oh, wow. So that might be something that appeals to you. And certainly, I'm sure it appeals to a lot of people in Rhode Island. And now they're going to be expanding that program, expanding that option. I have WPRI on in the studio here. They just showed a shot of the Fairhaven, New Bedford Bridge in the fog. And you could barely see the bridge. That's how thick the fog is right now. I also mentioned before the news that I wanted to talk about an article that I have at WBSM.com and on the WBSM app about the Lakeville Tower. And you might not even be familiar with the Lakeville Tower. You might have driven through Lakeville and all over Lakeville for years and not known about the Lakeville Tower. You might have actually had relatives that lived the next street over and not known about the Lakeville Tower. How do I know that that's possible? Because that was me. My in-laws lived on the next street over. And I used to walk around the neighborhood, and when my son was little, we'd push him in the carriage around, and I used to keep my motorcycle in my in-law's garage, and I would go there after work and pick it up when I was working in Lakeville, and I was there all the time. I didn't know about the Lakeville Tower until last summer, I believe it was, or fall, when Stephanie Burke said to me, I'm going to take Scott to see the Lakeville Tower. Do you want to come with me? And I said, okay, what's the Lakeville Tower? I had no idea. And so after I went and visited, I spoke to the president of the Lakeville Historical Society, Brian Reynolds, and I apologize. I forgot about this story. Like, I got wrapped up in covering something else and didn't go back to finish the story. So I just remembered it. I was thinking about it yesterday, and I was like, hey, you know, I never did write that story in the Lakeville Tower. And so then I went in and finished it. So now I pose the question, Lakeville Tower, mundane or mystery? And this doesn't come from me. I know that a lot of you out there are like, oh, Tim tries to see the paranormal or the weird and everything. And I do. And I'm not ashamed of that. But in this particular case, it was actually the Historical Society president that was bringing up some of these things. So the mundane part of this is the explanation for what the Lakeville Tower is. And you can see photos of it in the story on the website and on the app. But the mundane explanation is that it is the Lakeville Sailors Home Tower. Because in the late 1800s, and we get into the story, we get into some of the history of the property. There used to be Samson's Tavern. This was all part of that big piece of property that Samson's Tavern was on and all of that. But basically, the bottom line is a portion of that farm, of that property, was sold. And it was purchased by a company that was called the National Sailors Home Corporation. And what this company did is they would build homes for Civil War soldiers that were like, you know, like nursing homes or a place for them to live out their days, taking care of the veterans from the Civil War. So this particular organization built homes for Civil War era sailors. We're talking, you know, 20, 25 years after the war had ended. And they built one in Quincy. They built one in Marshfield, Duxbury area. They built one down the Cape, but they were looking to put another one in Lakeville. So they purchased a piece of property and they constructed this stone tower that would have a water tank on top of it. This would be where they would have the water for this home. You know, back then it wasn't piped into your house underground. A lot of people had wells. This would be a tower that would be both for their drinking water and, you know, in case of fire, they'd have water ready to put out the fire. Because this was going to be a pretty significant structure. So they built the stone tower, but then never built the actual sailor's home because the Depression hit and they ran out of money. So they decided not that they didn't need another sailor's home with others relatively close. So the tower remained on the property as the property changed hands. It was purchased by a family called Phillips. That family, their daughter inherited it. She married a man named Gibbs. They owned it eventually. A family named Bartlett took over. And they ended up donating the tower to the Lakeville Historical Society. So by all accounts, it was something that was built in 1882 for this sailor's home. But Brian Reynolds, the president of the Historical Society, unprompted by me, although he was aware that I was someone who researches the Bridgewater Triangle and other strange things, he brought up the fact that there is a particular stonemason who has examined the tower, who believes that the mortar holding it together is newer, but that there's reason to believe that there's parts of it that are older than what is believed. That this tower actually could have been standing a lot longer than from 1883. There's nothing that the Historical Society has been able to find in their records that would indicate that it was there previously. But they are open to the possibility. For example, and some of it is, you know, based in history. There's some books from the colonial era that mention the Middleborough Powder House, but nobody knows the location of the Middleborough Powder House. It's believed that this stone tower, if it was around in those times, could have been the powder house. It's reasonable enough to think when the next street over from where the tower is located is called Old Powder House Road. So maybe somebody that named it that was thinking that it was the powder house, even though the road doesn't actually go to the tower. Another part of the story is a lot of the hills that are in the area might have been made by the Native Americans. There's a spot called King Philip's Lookout right near the tower where Metacom or King Philip apparently used it as a lookout. But there's the possibility that King Philip Hill was constructed by the Native Americans, that it's not natural that they actually constructed it bringing baskets of sand over, baskets of earth over, and building up this hill to be a watch point, a lookout. And if that's the case, did they do that because this tower was already there? There's even the possibility that it may be connected to the Newport Tower, although there's nothing to suggest that. It's just something that's been thrown out there as a theory. And as you know, the Newport Tower is mired in mystery. Some people feel that it is nothing more than an old windmill. But it's a windmill where it lines up with the solstices coming through those windows that are supposedly where the wooden beams came in for the, you know, the propeller portion, whatever they call the blades of the windmill. But yet that perfectly aligns with the solstices. Now, the Lakeville Tower does not align with the solstices. But those towers could have been built as marking points for something. So, you know, it's easy to say, well, if you want to know how old the tower is, why don't they just do carbon dating on it? Well, of course, but what are you going to do? Carbon date the stones? You're going to find out that the stones that comprise the tower are thousands, if not millions of years old, which, of course they are. That's how rocks are formed. That's how stone comes to be. It doesn't mean that that's when they were placed there. So it may be eternally a mystery, or it might just be mundane, and it might be it's nothing more than the water tower that was constructed for the sailor's home. But it's still fun to think about the possibilities, and so check out the story, check out the photos at WBSM.com and on the WBSM app. And if you are, you know, out and about and you want to stop by and take a look, it is literally on Heritage Hill Golf Course. So right next to the clubhouse, they have the tower. You can walk up into it. You can take photos. So go ahead and check it out for yourself. See it for yourself. And see what you think. 508-996-0500. I'm going to take a break. We'll be back in a few moments. All right, welcome back in. 508-996-0500. You can also use App Chat and Open Line voicemails on the WBSM app. Don't forget, coming up in the next hour, in the 8 o'clock hour, we will start your chance to win cash. 10 chances every day. We do a different code every hour, starting at 8 a.m. through the 5 p.m. hour. And each time you hear that code, if you go and enter it at WBSM.com or on the WBSM app on the Win Cash page, so you have to go to Win Cash at the top of WBSM.com or click on the Win Cash money bag icon on the WBSM app. And when you enter in the code, each time you enter it, you have the opportunity to win $100. And then each one of those entries puts you in the drawing for the grand prize of $30,000. So 10 chances every single day to get your name in to try to win $30,000. So just go to WBSM.com or the WBSM app to find out more about it. It's brought to you by Architect Managed IT Services. Win cash on WBSM. All right, now it's time to go into the newsroom and get all the headlines with Phil Devitt.
Arizona Democrats try and fail to repeal an abortion ban. Rent prices on the rise, and two guilty pleasures join forces for your eating enjoyment.
From the WBSM newsroom, this is WBSM News.
Arizona Republicans are halting efforts by state Democrats to throw out a controversial law banning almost all abortions in the state. In the State House Wednesday, Republican Representative Matt Gress joined Democrats in trying to bring a bill forward to stop the ban, with a motion in the Senate also denied. The Arizona Supreme Court is upholding the abortion ban, which dates back to 1864 and bans all abortions except for risk to the mother. Tornadoes tore through Louisiana and Texas on Wednesday, ripping apart roofs, damaging homes, and downing power lines. The Louisiana Twister was on the ground for a mile, while the one in Texas carved a 2-mile path of destruction. High winds, heavy rain, and hail also wreaked havoc across the region. President Biden is calling on Hamas to agree to the administration's new proposed ceasefire deal with Israel.
They need to move on the proposal that's been made. And as I said, we'll get these hostages home where they belong, but also bring back a 6-week ceasefire that we need now.
Biden made the remarks Wednesday during a White House news conference. The U.S. has been working with Egypt and Qatar to broker a deal between Israel and the Palestinian militant group. The deal reportedly involves a six-week ceasefire in the Gaza Strip and the exchange of Palestinian prisoners for 40 hostages held by Hamas ever since the deadly attacks of last October 7th. Rent prices are up for the third straight month. According to real estate company Redfin, they're also up 0.8% from last year. Median rent as of March is at $1,987. Rents had cooled in the previous three-month period, but they're now beginning to ramp up again, along with inflation. Bipartisan lawmakers are introducing bills in Congress that would address rising anti-Semitism in the U.S. Tammy Trujillo reports.
Democrat Jackie Rosen of Nevada and Republican James Lankford of Oklahoma are sponsoring the Senate's Countering Anti-Semitism Act, while Democrat Kathy Manning of North Carolina and Republican Chris Smith of New Jersey are co-sponsoring a House version of the bill. Rosen, who's Jewish, said in a statement that anti-Semitism has been dramatically rising in the U.S. in the last several years. She says the new bill would establish a national coordinator to counter anti-Semitism for the first time ever. I'm Tammy Trujillo.
And Krispy Kreme is now making Kit Kat donuts. Tasty details from Mark Mayfield.
The donut maker says it's introducing three new flavors with the popular candy bar. The Kit Kat Crunch is going to be a glazed donut topped with pieces of Kit Kat bars. The Kit Kat Cookie Dream Donut is going to be chocolate-filled with cookie dough-flavored cream and covered in Kit Kat pieces. And the Kit Kat Salted Caramel Brownie Donut is going to be sprinkled with Kit Kat and brownie pieces, finished with a caramel drizzle. The Krispy Kreme Kit Kat Donuts will be available for a limited time only. I'm Mark Mayfield.
WBSM Sports.
The Boston Red Sox lost to the Baltimore Orioles 7-5 last night. Third time's a charm today at 7 at Fenway. The Celtics welcome the New York Knicks to TD Garden tonight at 7:30.
Now your ABC 6 South Coast forecast.
We have a wind advisory that will go into effect overnight tonight and into tomorrow afternoon. Coastal flood advisory as of 6 p.m. We have a storm system incoming. Patchy drizzle this morning. Areas of fog, cloudy around 50. This afternoon, cloudy mid-50s with a chance of showers. Light, very low possibility for some showers. Overnight tonight, the rain chances increase as well as the wind. From the ABC 6 Weather Center, I'm meteorologist Cecil Carmen on New Bedford's News Talk Station 1420 WBSM.
This WBSM news update brought to you by Ocean Wine and Spirits Liquors for the largest selection of nips near Fairhaven, now open at 157 Pope's Island in New Bedford. I'm Phil Devitt for WBSM News. Stay up to date with New Bedford's News Talk Station WBSM and get all of our content and breaking news alerts with the WBSM app.
That is the new track from Pearl Jam, Dark Matter, the title track of the album that will be released on April 19th. But if you want to get a chance to hear it ahead of time, there are only two record stores in Massachusetts that are getting the opportunity to have a listening party where you can hear the album before it's released. You know, we were talking about wanting to sample alcohol before you buy the bottle. This is your chance to sample music before you buy the album. Now, the people who are going to be attending this likely aren't going to be people who are, I'm casually interested, but I don't want to commit necessarily to buying the album. These are going to be people that are diehard Pearl Jam fans that can't wait to hear the new album. And if that's you, if you are one of those folks, if you are looking for your chance to hear the album first, well, it'll be happening this Sunday at Max J Records in Fairhaven. We have a story at WBSM.com and on the app about how they're one of only two record stores in Massachusetts that have been given the green light to play this on Sunday at 2 p.m. You have to RSVP, which you can do at maxjrecords.com, max, the letter J, records.com. The link is in the story that we have on our website and on our app. And there's going to be some giveaways, and you can pre-order the album while you're there, and you get to hear it in its entirety. And if you would rather go and have a place where you can sit down and listen to it, there's a number of movie theaters that will have it on the 16th where you can hear it. Those are all listed in the story as well. So if you're a Pearl Jam fan, check that out. I RSVP'd myself a spot, so maybe I'll see you down there on Sunday. Also, very quickly, just want to let you know that some of you out there, I know I see people all the time still interested in finding some work, whether it be a full-time job or some extra money, maybe a little bit of something to supplement your retirement, maybe a little bit of something to just earn some extra money while the kids are in school. Trembly Bus is looking for school bus drivers, monitors, and van drivers. Again, a great job for retirees, for stay-at-home parents, or for anyone looking to earn great pay while supporting local students. And if you are interested but you don't have your CDL, that's okay. They are willing to train you if you are willing to learn. Now is the time to apply to make sure you can get everything ready to go by the time the school year starts back up in September. If you want to find out more information, go to tbcbus.com. That's TBC, Trembly Bus Company, tbcbus.com. And join Trembly Bus Company today. All right, 508-996-0500. That's our number. Let's go to the phones. Good morning. You're on WBSM.
Hi, Mr. Weisberg.
Morning.
Good. I like two things to mention, but before I get to that, I don't know if you said anything, but I must have missed it if you did. But what did you have while you was at the creamery?
I just had a couple of cups of coffee, and then Lolly made me a sandwich to go before I left.
Yeah, a couple of cups of coffee.
Yeah, I tried a couple of different of their flavors. Really good.
Oh yeah, with the caffeine and all, huh?
Oh yeah, I usually have a big cup of coffee every morning. That's all that I usually have. But I have
nice to be young.
Pretty good one.
Nice to be young. Yeah. Okay, I was in the BSM thing. I saw the story about that tower. It interested me. It was very interesting. But when I go into anything that BSM puts on there, because I like reading, so I'll read whatever's there. But then I start scrolling, and they have other stuff as you go down. So I keep scrolling, and I came across that beautiful Fairhaven High School. Now, I'm from New Bedford. I've lived here all my life, but I've been by that school maybe 50,000 times in my life. And until I saw those pictures with all that detail in it, I want to go inside now, and I want to walk around. Now, can we just knock at the door, or do they have tours of the school? And now I'm going to really look it up. I want to know if it was always a school. I mean, that Huddleston, was that his home at one time? Was it a castle? It looks like it.
Nope, it was built to be a high school by Henry Huddleston Rogers. He wanted it to look that way.
And he had visitors, Mark Twain and everybody.
Yeah.
I read the whole thing. And it was so interesting that...
I was going to say, have you seen some of the other buildings that Henry Rogers built? Because they all have kind of a similar style.
Well, I may have seen it and just don't know what I'm looking at.
I know you've been in the Millicent Library.
Yes.
Yeah, I was one that he built that.
That's beautiful.
Yeah.
Yeah. And then if you go further down, because I know we don't have a lot of time to talk about the school, but I would like to go inside the school.
I would say, on that point, I would say reach out to Chris Richard at the Fairhaven Tourism Office. He would know better if they do something like that. Maybe in the summertime they do something like that when school isn't in session.
Yeah, because I didn't think that they would be object, you know. And so if you go further down, I got to the segment, what do you call it, a segment, or I don't know what you, an article? You keep going down, it's other stuff. So it showed the state reservation, the Fort Phoenix. Now, people were able to send in comments, and it shows all the comments. Now, all through the whole article, they only showed this one same picture over and over. They didn't show any other parts of the reservation, other beaches, or nothing. It's just that one picture, so all the way down. But people like me can make comments. I don't know how you post that, but I saw it, and I was reading it all the way down. And then somebody was answering what the commenters were saying. Now, I'm thinking it's the woman that maybe, because there's a name at the top, and it's, I'm trying to look at it now, and I went too far down. I don't know if she was one of Kate Robinson? Do you know her?
Yeah, she was our news reporter. Then she moved to Vietnam.
Okay. She's gone. So, but the story's here now.
It's just one that she wrote before. Yeah, she probably wrote it when she was here.
Okay. So I'm thinking she might be the one that replied to the comments that people were making. And I'm going to tell you, I enjoyed that segment of this thing because she had some great answers. It was funny. It was wonderful. And a lot of people, when I saw what they were commenting, she gave them the right answers. I mean, one person commented on the photo and said, body dump. You can dump bodies over there. It looks like you could. And I thought to myself, she's crazy. And then somebody else said, I don't go there anymore because there's always dog poop everywhere. Let me tell you, I've been going there since I was 5 years old. My dad always took the whole family there. Plus, I'm older. I've been going there. I'm going to be 72. I've been going. I know that place better than anybody, and I've never seen, not once, any dog poop. I see people cleaning up after their animals all the time. If there was any poop ever, I missed it. But this lady said, dog poop all over, garbage everywhere. Never seen it.
Nope.
And then somebody else commented, I'm not going to go there because you can't take your dog there no more. I saw dogs there last week. Are we not supposed to bring a dog there? I didn't know.
I didn't know either.
I don't know. And then some other guy commented. He says, no, I'm not going to go there because they refused me a beach pass because I live in Mattapoisett, not New Bedford. I don't pay to park. I go there. I park anytime I want. So I don't know what a lot of these people are saying. Oh, there's no snacks. There's no eating. I will say that when I was very young and my dad took us there, they had that. We could get clam cakes and french fries and quahogs. It was nice. I wish they would bring that back to that building that's there. And I don't know why they stopped it, but they did, and it was fun. My whole life was spent at that beach. It was wonderful. I didn't see nothing wrong with it. And they had so many complaints, but that woman, Kate Robinson, she answered them so well. And it's funny. Have you seen it at all?
No. I'll have to take a look.
Right under the high school story, right under there. It's the turbines first. The turbines, and then it's the high school, and then it's the state reservation, the beach. And you've got to read that. Everybody has to read it. I got a big bang out of it. If anybody knows that beach like I do, you got to go over there. It's really, that's a beautiful place. And how dare they? There's only one thing that bothered me. I forgot when they did this, maybe a couple of years ago. Because every time I go up Route 6 going that way, and the sign on Route 6 that says state reservation, you know, down that road there, they changed the color. The old sign that used to be green, we still have green signs. They changed it. They put that dark brownish color. I didn't like that. I felt, I don't know, the first time I ever looked at it, I said, why did they change
that? That seems to be the new format for state parks and state forests and all that stuff.
Oh, I don't like it. Why can't they just leave things alone? That's one memory I had, too, was that sign. And now it's changed. When I first saw it, you see how things bother me? Why couldn't they just leave it alone? Oh, another lady said there was garbage all over the beach. Come on. Sometimes if I go there very early in the morning and the guy hasn't come yet to clean up whatever happened overnight, but usually it's pretty nice. It's not that bad. I don't know why they can complain. That is the best place in Fairhaven. I'm sorry. Okay, I went over.
All right. Well, I would agree with you. It is a great place. Thank you for the call.
It is.
You have a good day.
Bye-bye.
All right. I do have to take a break here. We'll be back in just a few moments. Stay tuned.
Up.
Welcome back. And I got an email from Joe who says, and you can email me anytime, tim@wbsm.com. You can also send app chat messages on the WBSM app. But Joe, who didn't specify where he was listening from, but I'm assuming he is someone who is interested in the Lakeville Tower because he said he's seen it many times. Maybe he's a golfer. Maybe he golfs at Heritage Hill. But he says he's seen it many times and never gave it a second thought until he read that article and wanted to know, what do I think it is? And I've got to tell you, my gut is telling me that it's just a water tower. You know, Occam's razor, the simplest explanation is the right one. And in this case, the recorded, you know, answer is the right one. The one that's historically recorded. I don't think there's anything more to it than that. However, you know, as I mentioned, the president of the Historical Society leaves the door open for the possibility that there could be more. But I think that it's probably just that that's what it is. But people are looking for connections. They're looking for similarities. They're looking for a reason why there's a tower in Newport, a tower in Lakeville. I think there's another one north of Boston. You know, and why does Dighton Rock line up in a straight line as the crow flies from the Newport Tower and America Stonehenge in New Hampshire? Like, what is the... Well, America Stonehenge was something that was man-made. Okay, but what made the man want to make it? See, in a way, belief in the supernatural and the metaphysical is a lot of justifying as much as it is explaining. So the idea of saying, well, I don't think that that's what it is. Well, you don't know that. Well, you're right. I don't know that, but you don't know that it's true either. You know, that's why when people come and they play a clip for me and they're like, listen to this voice I captured. Like I captured this voice. I want you to hear it. And I'm like, okay. And I listen to it and they tell me what they hear. And I say, well, all right, I could see that. I can't say, no, that's not what I hear at all, because they get upset. When somebody shows me an orb photograph, which an orb is always, almost always, 95% of the time, dust or a bug or moisture that causes the camera to create this orb effect in the photo. They're all, almost all, easily explainable. But somebody will be like, no, that's Aunt Phyllis. That's Aunt Phyllis. She passed away when I was a kid. That's Aunt Phyllis right there. Okay. Because I don't know that it isn't. You know, Jeff Belanger taught me that. You don't know for sure, as much as you think that it's dust or bugs or moisture, you don't know for sure, so you have to leave open that possibility. So I just say maybe. So I'll say the same thing about the Lakeville Tower. Maybe. But I don't really feel that that's the case. But it's still fun to talk about and still fun to write. 508-996-0500. We'll be back in just a few moments. It's going to wrap up the next hour, this hour, and we're going to be back with you in the next hour. And in the next hour, we'll have your first cash code of the day, your first chance to win cash on WBSM. So stay tuned for that. It's brought to you by Architect Managed IT Services. And it's one of the many great contests that we have coming up. We're going to be giving away some tickets next week to some things, and we've got all kinds of giveaways planned.